Okay, so I wanted to know what are your guys' thoughts on Lil Nas X's new single that's gonna be coming out this Friday and all the controversy that's like surrounding it basically, because people are not happy with this, especially the Christians and things like that. I will say for myself, I'm not a particularly religious person. I think a lot of the backlash he gets really comes from the fact that he always has to have controversy to push his work, and this is something that I can't stand. Is he the first person to do this? Absolutely not. But I think it just, at a certain point, people get tired of it because it's like, why do you always have to have gimmicks behind your music and stuff like that? And I mean, I feel like he's already done something similar to this before in his last era. He had these Satan shoes released, and there was a lot of controversy behind that. And like every single drop, like last era, there was some controversy in some way. And I mean, yeah, look at the, quote retweets on the announcement. A lot of people aren't happy about this and everything, but there's other perspectives I wanted to share on this. I saw this one tweet that says he's not the first or last to do this, y'all just homophobes, and I read other people saying that these people got a lot of backlash for doing this. There's people that brought up Madonna and like a prayer, but I mean she got a lot of backlash from that. I believe Pepsi suspended their campaign with her, and like she got a lot for that as well. So I mean I think there are different factors that play into it. I think some people are just homophobic towards him, and obviously I think that that isn't right, and you have the religious crowd and all those things. I mean for me, I just don't really care for him as an artist. He's not really for me, like his music just kind of mid, and I just think that all the controversies that he keeps having behind this is just like not helping him. And I honestly feel like if he wants to have longevity, then he has to stop with the gimmicks and just put out the songs and go. Like I said in one of my videos, there's a difference between good controversy and bad controversy. Sometimes people get into controversy by accident, and you can look at things from 50 years ago retrospectively, and now it would not be a big deal today, but for the time it was. So there is that, but I mean, from everything I see, he's causing this on purpose and he continually does it, and I just figure that it gets annoying, and that's kind of my thoughts there, and I wanted to say that. Also, I forgot to mention that he has a documentary coming out. I don't know what they're going to be documenting. I don't know if it's just like his whole career at this point, which, hasn't been much. I mean, he has had some successful singles. I won't take that away. I don't know if it's the new album, but, that's coming. So, I mean, we'll see about that. I'm not watching it, but, there's that. And then the last thing I want to mention on this conversation is he made this tweet a couple days ago talking about, "I love this constant cycle the world has with me. When I started making music, y'all told me I was just another Twitter rapper, then I made the biggest song of all time." No, you didn't. There are songs that are bigger than Old Town Road. And not to mention that he did all of those remixes to keep it at number one, which is inorganic. Y'all know I drag Taylor Swift for that because I think that if a song is organic, you don't need to release a bunch of remixes. Like Harry Styles, as it was, he didn't release a billion versions of the song. He did one version, it was number one for 15 weeks, and he didn't needs to do like all those things to try to keep it there. So there's that. Talk about y'all call me a one-hit wonder, then I dropped one of the most streamed albums of the year with 3 top 5 hits. Fine, he can have that. I'm not gonna argue that point. Now y'all saying my new shit not finna do nothing. At some point, y'all gotta realize I'm God's favorite. And I mean, at this point, I just feel like just because you have like a few successful eras or a few successful songs, like I was kind of talking about earlier, that doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to have longevity. Like maybe he will change his ways, with his next single or his next era, or maybe I'll be wrong and just like we'll see how everything goes. But I just, like I said, I feel like if he continues to go his way, he's not gonna have longevity. Like there's so many artists that have like a big 5, 10 years and then you don't hear from them again, and you don't really get why they're so popular unless you're around at the time, and I feel like that's what's gonna happen with him. Like I said, maybe I'm wrong, we will see what happens, but I just think that this whole thing of causing controversy is getting old. I'm so tired of the gimmicks and all these things. But I want to know what you guys are thinking of this down below in the comments, because I talked with my friends about this, and some of them were like, "I'm not Christian, I'm not offended, I think it's kind of funny that he's doing this," and all these things. Like I said, I'm not religious, but I mean, I think that constantly, like, poking the bear, like, with all this stuff, like, I mean, I think it gets kind of old. Okay, so I made a follow-up TikTok to this, and I was basically just talking about how the song was slated to debut at number 80, and about how his song basically didn't do what he was expecting. That whole tweet that was talking about, "Oh, y'all think my new shit not finna do nothing, it aged like milk." And the song actually ended up debuting at number 69. A lot of it was just points that I echoed the first time, so I figured it'd be redundant to put those two together, so I'm doing this voiceover. Something that I forgot to talk about is he had people dress up like celebrities. Like there was Mariah and like some other celebrities and stuff like that. I just didn't like it. I thought it was kind of tacky and everything like that, and just kind of added insult to injury in my opinion, especially Mariah, because on the little Twitter account he had, he was literally saying all the stuff about Mariah, talking about, "Oh, she can't sing anymore, more, and da-da-da-da-da, and was talking all this trash. And he did a lot of that for a bunch of famous pop stars. I'm not even gonna repeat all the stuff he said because Love is horrible. He can lie and say it wasn't him, but I think that he's just saying that it wasn't him tweeting those things because he doesn't want the controversy and everything. But I did not forget, and that's one of the reasons that I don't like him. And so, yeah, that was just another thing about this entire rollout that I didn't really care for. But I wanted to know, what do you guys think about his explanation in terms of the stuff that he posted on social media and everything? Are you buying it? Are you not buying it? I mean, for me, I don't really care for the explanation in general. I feel like the only reason he did that is because the backlash for the song and the fact that his song flops. Had the song actually done well, then he would have been like, oh, see, I won again. All y'all haters, like, y'all not gonna be seeing me. And like, I did what I had to do. But because of those two things, he felt like he had to like put something out there or whatever. And I feel like he's just trying to save his own reputation, public standing, all those things. So I kind of just wasn't buying it. I just felt like it was a bunch of BS. And so I wonder if now, with all this backlash and all this, if he's finally going to change his tune and do something different with his marketing. Is he gonna keep going into controversy and just try different ones and hope that next song is successful? Is he going to just find a different way? Because I was on a space with my Twitter friends, and they were basically just saying like he could have done a different controversy, and they were kind of giving ideas as to what he could have went with, and I could see their perspective on that, sure, but I wonder if this is it for him in general with that, and we'll see what he does with his next singles, with his album, with the career at large. I posted about this on TikTok like weeks ago whenever the song originally dropped and like all the controversy and stuff, and I didn't want to upload it on here at first. I was like, yeah, I'll just keep it for TikTok, but I really thought about it. I'm like, oh, I should have posted this weeks ago. But what really helps me is, you know, the new updates around the situation and everything, the song debut, all the things. So yeah, I talk about pop culture a lot and like pop music and things like that on here in current events, so I figured that I might as well end up posting it. So I hope that you guys enjoy it. Let me know your thoughts on this down below in the comments.